Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to use YUP for schema validation. So consider that your form is having like 10 to 20 fields or more than that, and every form field has their own custom validation criteria. In that case, writing the code in the validation property of formic is not good because the code will grow. Instead of that, there is an additional library we can use, YUP, which will do the validation for our form with the custom schema. Okay, so let's get started how we do it. First of all, what we need to do is we have to introduce YUP in our module. So we just introduce it something like this, and we will add this as a dependency. So first of all, we just go to the directory and do npm install. So npm install. Once this is getting installed, we can start our work. Okay. Now, what we need to do is we can create a schema. So const form schema. Okay. And this will use yup. We are importing dot object, and the shape of the object is, so here we are deciding the shape of the object. So it will have an email, password, all these fields, right? So we can write the validation criteria for each and every property. So here we can define the validation criteria for every property. So we have email, password, and there is one more property, name. Similarly, if we have more properties, then you can define the validation criteria for each and every property. Name is of type string, minimum should be 4, name must be 4 characters min, and name is required. Similarly, if any other field is there, you keep adding the validation mechanism. Okay, so here we are doing for email, invalid email address format. Okay, so it is taking care of that. So yup.string.email means you should follow the email regex. Email is required, right? Here the min property means password should be of minimum 3 character, name should be of minimum 4 character, and required. So two validation criteria has been added for every property. Now, how to actually integrate it with our formic? So nothing, very simple. Here we are doing validate. So we'll just remove this method and we will just use this form schema for the validation. So here, instead of validate, first of all, validate is a function. So we have to replace it to validation schema. Here is validation schema, and we can pass our form schema which we have created. Okay, this is simple. Now we have other things also, like on submit methods and all are working in the same way. Now if you see how it is going to work, it is kind of similar. Touch dot name, all the validation scenarios will be the same. We can save it and we can see how it is working. We can say name is required. Okay, yeah, all the messages are started coming, right? This is what we have added. Email address, password is required. So these messages are coming from this validation properties. So this is how we can integrate YUP with our form validation. Okay, now if I just provide the correct input, correct properties, that everything is fine, password validation and all. You can provide a nice and clean message by just customizing this error message component, provide a proper class, reduce the font size, put some line break, and show this below to the input text fields. That is just a customization. Here we are talking about logic, so I'm more concerned about it. So this is how you can actually show the particular error message and validation. Okay, I hope this is clear now. So this is about form validation. Here you can have n number of fields. You keep adding the validation for each and every field, and you can actually copy this schema into some other file so that your particular form will reduce to a less number of lines of code. Okay, so this is pretty much in this video. Next video we'll talk about little bit dynamic forms using formic component.